appreciate you for coming for this press conference, which was on fairly short notice. But I appreciate you for coming through. There is four quick issues that we would like to communicate about today. And some colleagues still getting set. Are we good to go? See, my friends from UBC are getting set. UBC is very dear to my heart because that's where I started my media journey in 2006. So when you see UBC people, please treat them nicely, even though their microphone is yellow. They are my friends. And we have been told about Bubu, by Uganda, Bill Uganda. So let's give our colleagues from UBC a minute. Are we ready? Yeah. Once again, I want to welcome you to today's press conference. Four quick issues that we'd like to communicate about. Number one, you have heard, as we are sitting here, there is tear gas, and I don't know if there is rounds of ammunition that have been fired. We are hearing explosives outside Parliament because casual workers of Kampala Capital City Authority are demanding their payment in arrears of about 4 months now. This issue has come up severally. We have discussed it on the floor of Parliament, and we have been given assurance. The Minister of Finance gave us assurance that money was released. KCCA gave us assurance that they had begun to pay these casual laborers and called on them to become. And they have become for some time. But I think they feel taken for granted. They continue to work. And for some reason, their payment does not come through. We do not understand why these people are taken for granted. One, they do very heavy work. They wake up very early, find them on the roads, 3 a.m., 4 a.m., cleaning the city to make it usable for every one of us. Sometimes they're even knocked because of the odd hours that they get to work. And as you know, some of our drivers, you know, who are defectless or some high, whatever the case might be, there has been accidents of some of these people. So they work under very gross circumstances. They're paid very little money. We understand about 150,000 per month on average. At times it is even less. Now, one, they are paid little money. We have actually advocated and made a case for them to be paid better. That has not happened yet. But number two, even the little money that is paid to them does not come on time. How do we expect these people to live? Children have now gone back to school. But somebody who is a casual worker and little money has not been paid for 4 months. We need to be fair. And our colleagues in government, you need to cease to see these as issues being raised by the opposition. You people are human. You earn salaries too. If you go for 2 months in your office without being paid, you'll raise a lot of dust. Why, how do you expect these people to live? So now they are protesting, and how are they being responded to? Explosives, as you can hear. I'm hoping none of them are being beaten, because in the past they were beaten up simply because they are demanding for what rightly belongs to them. Government needs to get organized. We have made a case for people who demand government. Government owes over 10 trillion shillings to people who provide services and they have not been paid, people who provide commodities and they have not been paid. Some of them it is food, some of them it is services like these workers and so on. And they have not been paid over 10 trillion shillings. How do we expect the economy to operate? Some of these business people actually borrow money from banks so that they can deliver a service, so that they can deliver on certain consignments and commodities, whatever the case might be. But you go for years without paying them, their businesses are crumbling, and then government says it is for the people. No. So we are demanding that the Minister of Finance helps us understand. First of all, to apologize, because he said that money had been released. How come that money is not being paid? He needs to explain to these casual workers and to us as leaders. But also want to understand, if it is true that finance releases that money, where is it stuck? Is somebody holding on to this money of these casual workers? Want to know, between Ministry of Finance and KCCA, where is the problem? Because these workers must be paid. And we want to appreciate them for speaking out, for even protesting peacefully. Because it looks like that's what this government listens to. When you engage, write letters and so on, nothing seems to happen. So I want to applaud them for speaking out and even protesting peacefully. It's unfortunate that their peaceful protest has been met by violence, but do not keep quiet. As we speak out here in Parliament, it is important that your voice gets to be heard so that your matters are addressed. The second issue that I would like to share with you is about the regional sittings of Parliament. As the Speaker was proroguing Parliament a couple of days ago, she announced that there's going to be regional sittings of Parliament in the next session, beginning in July. The Parliament is going to sit in different regions, starting in Gulu, Mbale, Masaka, Mbarara, and so on. Now, firstly, we as the opposition have always said that Parliament should get close to the people. It should go to where the people are. Incidentally, we did not mean physically that they, you know, that all of us as MPs, staff, and so on, and carry the mess and maybe furniture, whatever the case might be, that we take these things to the people. That's not what we meant. What we meant is that Parliament should be able to connect with the people and address their concerns. Listen to the cries of the people. These issues that you keep tabling, roads that are in a pathetic state, hospitals that are in a shambolic state, and so on and so forth. Parliament should be able to address those concerns of the people. That's what we meant by saying Parliament should get close to the people. That Parliament should be a people-centered Parliament. I've said that several, because that's our vision as Parliament. A people-centered Parliament. That does not mean necessarily that all of us go and have a session there. No, it means addressing the concerns of the people. That in our deliberations, the people are at the center. In the budget that we pass, in the laws that we make, the people are at the center. The challenge that is that these regional sessions, the plan around it is problematic. I wrote a letter to the Speaker last week. And in this letter, I asked the Speaker, number one, it's important that the business committee should have sat regarding this issue. If Parliament is going to sit regionally, the business committee, which plans for the sittings of Parliament and those other activities, should have sat. The business committee has not sat. I also put it to the Speaker in this letter that I wrote last week. I said, these sittings have got a financial implication. If you're going to carry 529 members of Parliament to Gulu, for example, plus staff of Parliament, it means transport, fuel, per diem, and so on and so forth, for all those MPs and for all the staff. So I was asking the Speaker, when did the Parliamentary Commission sit to pass this issue? Because it has got a financial implication. And matters of finance here at Parliament are dealt with by the Parliamentary Commission, not a single individual. The Office of the Speaker, Deputy Speaker, Leader of Government Business, all of them received my letter. I've not got a response to this letter. And so we, the opposition, are concerned. We are saying, how are these things happening? I'm sure, of course, people would be excited in whichever part of the country to receive members of Parliament, the 529 of us. There would be a bit of excitement and so on. But beyond that, what exactly do these people want? They want service delivery, not us just going to them. But also the process of how this is being handled is problematic. Because the business committee did not sit. The Parliamentary Commission has not sat. So who sat as the Parliamentary Commission? Did the Speaker sit on her own and say, I'm now the Commission, and so I passed this issue, including the billions of shillings that this would require, because it would mean billions of shillings for all these 500 plus MPs and all the, I don't know how many staff that we would need, people going to spend their days and so on and so forth. So I'd like to encourage the Speaker of Parliament, allow the systems to work, allow the institution to function. The Parliamentary Commission last sat in August of last year. From January of this year, when I became leader of the opposition, I became part of the Parliamentary Commission. I've not attended even one single Parliamentary Commission meeting. Why are we operating this way? What's being hidden? Because when things happen this way, people even begin to assume that maybe this is being done to account for some money, some billions of shillings. It's important that we operate in the open. And that's what I was telling the Speaker in this letter. The Business Committee should see it. The Parliamentary Commission should see it and pass this issue, because it has got a financial implication. It should not be one individual sitting over these matters. I'm yet to get a response from the Speaker, because I understand meetings are happening of staff and so on. Subcommittees have been put in place to prepare. But we, the leaders, do not know. As leader of the opposition, I've not got a formal communication about this, apart from her pronouncement. Because when she made a pronouncement, it should be followed up with details. And the details have not come. Do not know. But meetings are happening. So we are saying it's not right that we are kept in the dark. Because then it becomes suspicious. While these things are happening very quietly, we are not given any information. Even when I write a letter, it's not responded to. So they think that we are all in this together. No, we are not. As the opposition, we are not. We don't know. That's why I'm writing to the Speaker to say, provide us with this information. How was this determined? It's important. It's important that we are transparent how we get to operate. Otherwise, the public out there is saying we should be working hard to reduce our expenditure. But now, we are increasing our expenditure, unnecessarily so. Because the people of Gulu, what they want is good roads. What they want is for Lacho Hospital in Gulu to be equipped with medicine, with doctors, and all the equipment that is needed. What they want is the schools in Gulu and Northern Region, generally, to be functional. And that's the same case with the people of Eastern Uganda, Western Uganda, Central, the entire country. Not so much that as members of Parliament, we all travel and go there and then spend a lot more money. We can sit here in Parliament and discuss these issues, if we get to discuss serious issues. Challenges, sometimes the serious issues are not given attention. So the issue is not where we get to sit. The issue is, what issues are you tackling when you get to sit even here? And also, finally, this issue, we are saying committees should be empowered to do their work. Committees work on behalf of Parliament, and they go to the field. So if there is an issue in Gulu, in the West, in the East, and so on, there is a committee, there is a sectoral committee in that line. If it is health committee. If it is roads, there's an infrastructure committee, and so on and so forth. Let's empower the committees to do this work. Committees are normally complaining they're not facilitated to do their work. There is no money to go to the field. So where is money coming from for the entire Parliament to go? So as opposed to the 529 of us going to these areas, let's empower committees to do their work. That's the work of committees. They go to the field, find out what they have found, interact with the locals, come back to Parliament, give us a report, we discuss, and then we tell the executive what to do. We believe that that's how things should be operating. Number two, the State of the Nation address is happening the day after tomorrow. And the budget speech is next week. Firstly, regarding the State of the Nation address, this shadow cabinet, because this is the shadow cabinet, we've held a meeting, and we have agreed not to attend the State of the Nation address and the budget speech for these reasons. The State of the Nation address consistently has become just ritualistic. Mr. Museveni comes to speak to the nation and is regurgitating the things he said in 1990, in early 2000, and so on. Just for your information, I have actually already prepared my response to the State of the Nation address, because within our rules of procedure, the leader of the opposition is meant to respond to the State of the Nation address. My response is ready, as of last week. You know why? Because I know what he's going to say. That's the reality. So my response is actually ready. It was ready last week, because I know what he's going to say. So we think that that address, it is a mockery to the people of Uganda. People of Uganda want to hear, how are you tackling corruption? As opposed to defending it. How are you dealing with service delivery issues? How are you working hard enough to cut down on the expenditure? Firstly, your state house, which spends over 2 million per day, to make sure that there is money available for service delivery. How are you dealing with human rights violations? Critical issues that the people of Uganda want to hear, followed by action. That's never the case. So we as the opposition are saying we don't want to escort Mr. Museveni in this region which is not making sense to the people of Uganda. We shall have our chance on the floor to have our response on what is critical that the people of Uganda want to hear. Because even by not attending, you know, we shall get to know what we have said on social media, but also we'll get a copy of that document. So no one can say, but what will you be responding to if you won't be attending? Like I've told you, it is ready, my response, because I know what he has always said and what he will say, but we shall also get a copy. But importantly, it is us saying the people of Uganda are tired of the ritual. They want real substance, and we as their representatives, we don't want to accompany you in just a mere ritual that does not make sense. The budget speech. Some will say, but you as MPs, the budget speech is, you know, the budget is yours collectively. You pass it together. Why? You can miss the State of the Nation address, but why would you miss the budget speech? Again, the reality is, the budget that was passed, we as the opposition, we cannot call it our budget. No. We had our alternative budget, which we unveiled. We laid on table our alternative ministerial policy statements that feed into the budget. We tabled our minority report, which was pointing to what we need to, what the budget needs to focus on. Our views were disregarded because we were saying we need to put more money in service delivery. Kampala alone generates over 60% of the country's revenue, but look at the roads in Kampala. And we're saying, don't milk a cow that you don't feed. Put money there. Our views were disregarded. We said our debt burden, which is now at about 100 trillion shillings, we need to address it, first of all, reducing our appetite to borrow. Because even this money, when it's borrowed, what does it do? Much of it remains lying idle, and yet we have to pay interest. A year or two, it's not being utilized. There's no real value. Much of it is stolen. And so we're saying, can we reduce our borrowing appetite? Can we reduce on consumptive expenditure? When you see how much money is spent on a number of these votes, meanwhile, service delivery gets to suffer. So all these issues we adumbrated very clearly in our alternatives, but they were disregarded. You saw how the budget process, the appropriation was handled. A core agenda was brought last minute, adding 14 trillion shillings to the budget. Last minute. They pushed it through, and because they have the numbers, it passed. So we are saying, no, this is not the budget of the people of Uganda, the kind of budget we would want to see. We have shared what the real concerns are, where we need to push money. Healthcare, roads that are in a shambolic state, education. Look at, you know, capitation grant that is sent per child, between 15,000 to 20,000 capitation grant per child, UPE, for an entire year, and you expect this child to compete globally. How? It does not make sense. So all these, as we did share in our alternative budget, our alternatives, our minority reports, but all of these were disregarded. So because they have the numbers, they passed what they want to pass. So it is not our budget, because our views were disregarded. Yes, we are in the minority, but listen to those views. Listen to what the people of Uganda are saying. They are always complaining and saying, but wait a minute, we need to cut down on the expenditure. So we have agreed also not to attend the budget speech because we are protesting what was encapsulated in the budget, disregarding critical issues of service delivery to the people of Uganda, but also the process. You saw at some point the speaker put the question, and it was clear who had the majority. Because she asked, I put the question, those in favor say aye, to the contrary, nay. And the resounding voice was clear, but she declared a different result altogether. People were shocked. So all of these processes, we are saying, this was problematic. And we don't want to just escort this. And by the way, this concern is not just of us in the opposition. Even some colleagues in the NRM, they were bothered and they expressed their concern with us and said, wait a minute, what just happened? How can a corrigenda be brought last minute and then it is pushed very quickly? It's as if we are hurrying to deal with I don't know what, because the budget should have been passed by the 31st of May. We had adequate time all through. Why things get to be done in such a hurry and others are being hidden underneath? So even some colleagues in the NRM are complaining and we are hoping that they will speak out as well. So this is not just a concern of we in the opposition, because even then, they want services delivered in their areas. And so they were saying, we need to cut down on some of these things. And so that is why we are saying we shall also not attend the budget speech, because we must be on record regarding the right things that should be done. Finally, there's an ongoing censure motion for the parliamentary commissioners. We want to appreciate members of parliament from the ruling NRM and the different opposition parties that have so far appended their signatures to this motion. We want to applaud them, because it's a bold move for those that have, because these commissioners, they are our colleagues, they are friends to many members of parliament, and so on and so forth. So it's a bold step for one to say that even though you're my friend, even though we belong to the same party, let me censure you because of an illegality and irregularity that did happen. So we appreciate everybody that has done so, and we encourage others that have not signed to sign, so that we rectify an irregularity that was occasioned. For people to sit and award themselves money in such a surreptitious manner a few months into the office, and they're giving themselves a service award. For what exactly? Now, we I've had some voices say that, but this money was passed by Parliament. Why are you people complaining? Is that actually true? When you read the Ministerial Policy Statement and the report of the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee, which handles the Parliamentary Commission, and you look at the budget that was passed, there's no such a thing as 1.7 billion shillings to go to Honorable Mpuga, Honorable Sirwani, Honorable Akampulira, and Honorable Afoyochan. It's not there. And I challenge any member of parliament to avail a document to that effect. It's not there. What we think could have happened, because in the Ministerial Police Statement and even the report, the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee, a case was made for a wage shortfall of 45.65 million, saying that this money had been cut as being part of the Parliamentary Commission. So it creates a wage shortfall. So Parliament resolved, let's reinstate that, so that there's no wage shortfall, so that people are paying their salaries, including staff and so on. So if it was hidden in such a figure, that makes it even more illegal. That makes it even more problematic. If it was hidden in the benefits of past leaders, that makes it problematic. Because the benefits of past leaders were debated on the floor of Parliament. Even when some of us had an alternative view, at least it was passed. And we know about it. And that's why you saw former speakers getting cards and so on and all of these different things. Yeah? Many of us were opposed, but the majority had that, so at least it was debated and passed. And we are, by the way, saying it's problematic when somebody who was former vice president, he was also former speaker and also former deputy speaker, is getting benefits of all those offices. It's shabby. It is wrong. But it was debated. And the majority had their day. When did Parliament debate this 1.7 billion shillings to these commissioners? When? Where are the documents to that effect? I challenge anyone to bring the hands and showing that we debated this issue. We did not. So if it was hidden somewhere within the lump sum and taken care of there, that makes it even more problematic. The more reason why we are censuring these commissioners, because we must operate transparently. If it was an okay thing, why did we debate it? A few weeks ago, Parliament debated a service award to the outgoing Auditor General. I stood up and said, this person is entitled to benefits. Let's leave it at the benefits that he's entitled to. But colleagues said, no, he also deserves a service award. And it was debated. In fact, somebody was suggesting 1 billion shillings. Eventually, Parliament zeroed down on 500 million shillings for Mr. John Mwanga, the outgoing Auditor General. It passed, even though many of us opposed it. But at least it was debated. When did we debate and pass this 1.7 billion shillings to these four people? Honorable Mathias Mpuuga, Honorable Solomon Siwani, Honorable Prosia Kampurida, and Honorable Esther Apoechan. We did not. So let's not hoodwink the public to say that those of us who are speaking about these issues, we are dishonest, we passed this thing. We did not pass it anywhere. So if you hid it somewhere within the lump sum budget, and that's where you're taking care of it from, that makes it even more problematic. The reason why these are our colleagues. In fact, we had expected that these are colleagues would be leaders worth their names and say, you know what, this is problematic, let's step down. Don't even wait for us to push you out. But since they've chosen not to do that, we shall do what we have got to do. And also to cleanse our name, because you cannot say we passed this and now we are being dishonest. We did not. And I challenge anyone to avail information to the contrary. Those are the four issues that I wanted to share with us. I can very quickly translate them into Luganda for your Luganda news.
Maybe just one question before.
Can we take the question, Doctor?
Yes,
let me first Adam read this, then you can take questions. I'm sure there are questions about a few other things. Also, can I add to Levaza, Kumanga Muze, for short notice? To what they know, Namu, the Pompole, Wero, Tiaga, Si, Ramunu Namasa, Si, Inamuchavi, Ulida. Abaposi, Bakesi, CA, Availing, Udonavara, Balimuke, Karakasa, Ruachi, Sente zaabwe kati emyezi ena tebazibawo. Abantu bano okusookera ddala akasente bafuna katono 15 omwezi. Ate nga bakola emirimu mingi, bakeera ssaawa 9 ssaawa 10 nga beera enguudo, abamu babakoona n'obakoona kubanga abatami babeera bavuga ssaawa ezo, bayita mu buzibu bw'ekitalo. Akasente bafuna katono, tunaka katono, tekatuuka ku bantu bano. Myezi ena, abaana kati bazzeeyo okusoma. Omuntu afunye kasente ke myezi ena, anaabeera watya, aneeriisa atya ne famire ye? Banaye tubeere fair. Minisita wa Finance namuteeka ku nninga mu Paalamenti, ebuvuddeko awo, n'atukakasa nga Paalamenti nti sente zo. Naye bo bagambye nti tujja kuvaayo, tubeebaza olw'obuvumu obwo. Nga bwe tubyogerako ebintu bino, amaloboozi gammwe nammwe gavengayo mu mirembe. Era kirungi eky'okujja ku Paalamenti nga mwekalakaasa, kubanga Paalamenti eyita sente zino. Minisita wa Finance ekitubuulira mu Paalamenti sente zaayitibwa. Kati kirungi ne muvaayo era temusirika, kubanga bw'osirika osigala onyigirizibwa. Mweyongere okwogera ku nsonga ezo, nannaffe eno bwe tulwana nga bwe tubuuza answers. Ensonga ey'okubiri, Oweekitiibwa Sipiika bwe yali aggalawo Paalamenti session eno, yalangirira nti session eddako Paalamenti egenda kutuula mu siti mu bitundu eby'enjawulo mu ggwanga. Yatandikira eggulu, tugende Mbale, Masaka, Mbarara na wa. Ffe mu opposition tuzze tugamba nti Paalamenti kikulu nnyo okutuukirira abantu. Naye ati tetwali tutegeeza nti Paalamenti yonna, nti kakati ababaka 529 n'abakozi bonna n'entebe ze tutuulako naki, tubisombe byonna tubitwale eyo. Nedda si kye twali tutegeeza. Twali tutegeeza nti obuweereza butuuke ku bantu, kubanga ffe
Vision ya figamba tuli people centered parliament ntimubuli chitukola abantu tubasoso baze amatekeka tuisa budget tuisa abantu bamere nyo ku mwanjo ngabaganyulwa mu nsonga zimuzi tutesako kitwali tutegeeza naye ati kakati bannaffe oba bakifuna bulala nti kati tusombe buli kimu buli omu n'ebintu byonna bitukozesa tubitwaleeyo ensonga eyo erina obuzibu bwa mirundi ebiri n'okubadde yesu of course bwe tugendeeyo mu bantu basanyuka ne balaba ku baraka bulijjo ababaka bulijjo bwe balaba ku tivi ne babalabako naye abantu ekyo si kye baagala just okututunulako baagala buweereza obuzibu bwe buli nti ensonga eno yali erina okutuula mu business committee okugiteesaako ekyo tekyaliwo yali erina okutuula mu parliamentary commission kubanga yiyisa ssente ekintu kino kiriko ssente mpitirivu nawandiikidde speaker ebbaluwa eno wiiki ewedde nga speaker mubuuza business committee yatuula ddi okupulaninga entuula zine zigenda okubeera mu bitundu by'eggwanga eby'enjawulo ekyokubiri parliamentary commission yatuula ddi okuyisa ssente zino kubanga bwoba ogenda kutambuza ababaka 529 n'abakozi bangi mulimu ensonga za kadiemu ya transport y'amafuta naki gyebagenda okusula eyo n'ebintu ebirina okusomba okutwala parliamentary commission yevunaanyizibwa ku nsonga za ssente za parliament yatuula ddi okuyisa ekintu kino kubanga zino ziba ssente empitirivu buwumbi na buwumbi so nga kuza speaker kyogamba watuula gwenga gwe newefuula komishoni kiba kikyamu kubanga zenga lead of opposition sikimanyiko ate nga ntuula ku komishoni naye bukyanga fuuka lead of opposition twabeerangawo commission meeting nemu in fact nategeezebwa nti commission meeting yasemba okubeerawo yali mu agasi omwaka oguwedde naye ebintu bisalibwawo sente ziyisibwa anyaziyisa nga commission tetudde abaffe commission etuulamu okutufa abamu abagituulaku nga tutegeeze ddewa nga tebatubuuliddeeko so speaker namuwandiikira n'agiriceivinga deputy speaker naye n'afuna kopi ye prime minister n'afuna kopi ye n'abalala tananziramu naye ate nga sikimanyiko tuwulira nti meeting zituula okuteekateeka ensonga zino okutuula mu bitundu by'eggwanga eby'enjawulo naye kakati ffe abakulembeze tetumanyiko ngaogyeko ekyo speaker kyeyalangirira oko maze okulangirira naye kiyise mu mitendera ne tukiteesaako ne tutegeera nti ssente zino zowe ziri kubanga ffe twalirowoozezza nti committees twali zempowerinze zezigende mu field nga zitukiikirira ffenna nga parliament ne committees zengulugunya tezirina ssente zimala okugenda mu field kakati ssente zine zitwala ababaka bonna buwumbi na buwumbi zo zivudde wa yekyo kyetaagisa kubanga abantu kye baagala tetuba tutudde wano mu parliament tuteese ku nsonga ezibaluma baagala ddagala amalwaliro gaabwe baagala nguudo baagala amasomero baagala buweereza kye baagala naye ate kakati abantu abatusuubira nti twali badde tukendeeza ku nsaasaanya yaffe ate tujongerako bwongezi obaolya mu kintu ekiteetaagisa so ninze speaker addemu ebbaluwa yange eno tanagiddamu kuva last week naye ate nga tuwulira enteekateeka zigenda mu maaso ffe lwaki batuggalira ebweru lwaki ebintu bino babikola mu nkutu fa opposition tituli part of parliament kubanga tetumanyiko nekifo opposition whip alina okuwipinga bamemba opposition bonna nti akakati bannaye tugenda mbaale katugenda gulu tugenda mbalala tetumanyi twebuuza lwaki ebintu bino bikolebwa mu nkutu fatu waliwo n'abalowooza nti oboolyawo waliwo abaagala okukola accountability embalirira nti kati yeno engeri egy'okubayamba okukola accountability eyo so kati abantu mugenda ne mbalowoozesa ebintu bingi kubanga temuvudde eyo temuli beerufu kikulu netubeera abeerufu mu nsonga zino ensonga endala ya state of the nation address ffe ngaaba opposition tutudde mu shadow cabinet netukkaanya nti tetugenda kwetaba mu state of the nation address ne budget speech lw'ensonga zino wammanga okusookera ddala state of the nation address amuseveni yagyonoona ge mazima ensonga bannayuganda zebamusuubira okwogerako tasookerako adda mu sitoole ati mukumu wenda chinana mukaga katu ingida wo nebirala mufu chokugira ku nsonga ezengizo eziluma banna Uganda obulyake okutulugunya abantu baliisa akakanja ne babawamba ne babasiba ebintu batwala egyo gyebitategeera ekitanda ki ensonga enkulu ensonga ez'obuweereza zamanyira okwogerako ezitasookerako bibeeranga ebyolusaagiriro kakati ffe tugamba nti nedda tetugenda kuwerekerango nga just oli muzannyo nadda mubacwezi nayogera ku bacwezi nayogera ku kino nga bannayuganda baagala ensonga enkulu ezibaluma
mumateeka nga lead of opposition nina okwanukula state of the national address era obudde obugenda tuuka ninjagala bategeeza nti okwanukula kwange statementi yange nagimaliriza dda last week kulwaki kubanga mwalimu emusebeni byagenda okwogerako byebijja gya updatingamuko katono kubanga byagenda okwogerako buli mwaka byayogerako so kati ffe tugamba nti tujja kubeerayo ekololo bwetuba twagala okutegeera biki byayogedde emitimbagano weegiri tujja funa ne kopi eyo tulabe biki byayogeddeko bigatta ku ggwanga naye kye tuzze tulaba nedda kyanjawulo so tugamba nti nedda tetujja kukuwerekera nga oyogera ku nsonga ezitaluma bannansi ate nga z'olina okuba nga oyogeraku ensonga eya budget speech era n'olunaku lwa budget tusazeewo nga kyano kabinet tujja kubeerayo ekololo era nga tukubiriza ne bannaffe ab'opposition netukiikirira tutambulira awo kale tugenda ku state of the national address ne budget waliwo abagamba nti naye budget yaffe ng'ababaka ba paalamenti newankubadde ffe tuli opposition naye ffe tugiyisa lwaki yo waki tetugendayo abantu abo nze mbabuuza nti budget yeeyo kweri yaffe kubanga ffe ng'aba opposition twafulumya alternative budget netufulumya ne alternative ministry of policy statements ne minority reports ku budget eno nga tugamba nti ensonga enkulu wetwali tadde ssente eyomuwa omusolo twongere ssente mu byobulamu twongere ssente ku nguudo tukendeze ssente zetwewola netuzoonoona nezibbibwa tukendeze ssente zisaasaanyibwa zitawuse kuzisa obuwumbi bubiri buli lunaku twongere ssente mu buweereza naye ensonga zaffe ne bataziwa makulu kakati bola okubanga balina ennamba ne bayisa kyebaali baagala kati ogamba otya kinaffe ekyo kyaffe ng'ate tetwalina endowooza endala zebaagaana okuwa amakulu ate ng'ensonga zino bannayuganda zeboogerako so ka tugamba nti bajeti eyo nedda newankubadde yeezi yayita naye tetwagiwakanya era tuli gurikot n'endowooza zaffe so ka tugamba nera tetwagala kuwerekera kintu kikyamu waliwo ekirala kyebayingizaawo kyebayita korigenda yabutabalika 14 trillion bakireeta last minute awo tebakiyise mumangumangu mu speedi bitugamba sokoleke lwaki ebintu bino tubikola mu ngeri yakwekwikirira lwaki tuli balambulukufu ne process mwagiraba sipiika n'abuuza ekibuuzo mu kulonda ababaka ne boogera kirala sipiika n'alangirira kirala ebintu ebyo bituswaza bannange kakati olwa consensus zitugamba nti nedda eyo bajeti si ya munnansi tetwabalaga bajeti yo eya munnansi sente wezirina okugenda wezirina okuteekebwa so netugamba nti neyo naye tetujja kubeerayo nga twolesa obutali bumativu bwetulina nga opposition ekisembayo waliwo censure motion egenda maaso okujja obwesige ku bannaffe ba commissioners kubanga baatuula ne beegabira akawumbi kamu million 7 nga beesiima oba baali beesiima ki ng'ate baali bagayingira office myezi bwezi ne batuula ne beesiima mu kukutu twagala okwebaza ababaka bonna aba NRM aba opposition ebina ebyenjawulo abavuddeyo ne basayininga motion eno kikolwa si kyabutiitiizi kubanga bakomisionaazi bano babaka bannaffe tutuula nabo mikwano gy'ababaka ab'enjawulo naye ababaka bagamba newankubadde muli bannaffe newankubadde muli mikwano gyaffe kino ekyakolebwa kikyamu
katubajemu uwezike banda fima nungunda yichibali jize na kubajemu uwezike bali gambi na yomaji chetuwa kula neta chichari chicha katule kulive beba agana katuwa sidi ikilize simu kutima kubina inga tuga mbachuino kuchilize chichamu chakulewa waleo banda faba kutende baga mantina ye mwe abagalo kujaba nangu uwezike nesongeno paramitri ya jisa waji mwaise chitu ate kakati mwefude yagala chogera mu lwatu wano parliament teisangako sente zino akawumbi akamu mu milioni olusanvu ezaweebwa honorable Matthias Mpuuga honorable Solomon Siwani honorable Prosi Akambulira honorable Esther Foyuchana parliament teisangako otunuulira ministry of police statement notunuulira committee ya legal parliamentary affairs committee evunanyizibwa ku parliamentary commission nula bani fajiti ya isi kwa temuli chintuti akawumbi akamumu milioni ulusambu okugenda kubantu ababana techilimu ila challenge ngomutu ye nagama antipala metia ziisa atulake zaisi wabuchumadi kochi debate ya lidi tuwabi debate inga kodi wanga bani zo kubanga banchi kweka kati echimu kwevi pala metia isa okudamu okuza wage sede sasuli wangu msala anawa kozi na chi zali zike indeleze duwa wame nega manele tuzizeyo nivonge na moko umbi ana mbutano kakati baba chukweka mwetu chichima mbu wajite te mwachi jemu mbulambu kufu wacho nezo ngeendala amumbaga mbanti chaitia chaita mu benefits the past leaders benefits za past leaders parliament yazite sako yeleje mvude mulaba abali basifika bafune moto kanibira niwa kubadde fa abamu twachi wakanya natuka mpanda yeso kuleke abantu bana abamu katiko wichi mchi kwa sekandi yali vice president yali speaker yali deputy speaker ni hata funa benefits za office zezu zona chichi amu so tuine vitu vingi vitu hawa wakanya ni at least chaita umuntu wabachi wole zezaga ba parliament ya chisa niwa kubadde twachi wakanya zinozo sente zina kaumbi akamu mmiyo olusaho zaitawa era ku hazardi anyaso bolo kujayo hazardi titwate sa kusonga zina tutu stesa ngako juzi bala me titwate sa ku kasimo aka auditor general unalimu kufuruma malize bilimu je mwami John Mwanga na yuko ina kufuruma inga mba nti nima nanga bamu nti omkulu ono aina benefits za ino kufuna afunezo na hecha service awali chaka simoneta nivale mela ko abamu ne bagamba in fact nga okwongera ku benefits ze tumwina akawumbi just ka kumusiima jebya ko era parliament neisa milioni bitano izaka simo service award twachi wakanya nature aita so kuliko ni kwechiri tino ku benefit twachi wakanya nature aita so kakati ejo hizo gama tichiri mateka kubanga abasi wa watu singe na babachi isa chine chaba na fe 1.7 billion chaita di twachi tesa ko dinga parliament so bana fe bali mekubuza abuza gwanga tipala me tumwa ise kitu kinateka kati mwe fudde nedda tetujisa ko wo bali nawo bachi kweka tikati sente zo bali nawo bazije atika tokubwa tuona musango mulala so ensonge eno tukyagiri ko eranga twebaza abasayini ze bonna okulaba nti twetiriza nga parliament mwe bali nyo
let's have questions first in English, then we shall do it in Arabic.
Morning, honorable members. Thanks for the opportunity. Dina. My name is Didan Kimati. A new vision is the outlet. I just want to ask you about the service award, because we have received very credible and terrifying information about a similar kind of award that's being propagated by your former colleagues, those who serve from the first parliament to the 10th parliament. And apparently, they are looking for a casino to start with of shillings 100 million, which they claim President promised them some time back in 2016. But the most scary part is that they have come up with a proposal whereby they need between 30-50% of the salary of the sitting MPs as a monthly pension. And when you tabulate that, that would come to 3.5 million. Remember, they are 1,142 as of now, according to their estimate. Secondly, they also need some money for funeral expenses. That is 30% of what you're entitled to. If you calculate that, that would come to 13.5 million. They are not done. They also need medical insurance. When you tabulate, according to their estimated number of 1,142, it will impose a charge of 3.4 billion a year. Their claim and their justification is that, like the Auditor General, like the Honorable Vice President and others, the authors of the nation, would you be prepared, if this thing came on the floor, to deal with it, to let them have their way, or it is immoral from the beginning? I would like to hear from you and the Honorable Members. Thank you very much.
Anybody else? Okay, Brenda.
Yes. Okay, we talked about that argument of legalizing parliament. Which parliament think is a necessity? Because it creates excitement and parliament needs serious PR. So, We have an economist in the office. Can you give us an estimate? How much is like a space on this?
Maybe just that other members of parliament say that you members of parliament don't want to read bulk documents. So that issue of the service award was, let me say, was among those bulk documents. So it's not therefore that you didn't read it. So what does that mean?
They say people don't attend paramedic service, just come complain after. It's a show just to put people on the service. There's problems. Because even this was voted by public, 40 million pieces.
Relatedly, mine is related to Gloria's issue. If this was, because there's a video showing Parliament supplying that figure. The question is
1.7 billion.
Yes. Go ahead. Okay, my question is, when do you ever question the budget of the Commission as Parliament, as MPs? We have seen you question other ministries, let's say Ministry of Health, you've questioned Magola's money. When do you ever question Commission money? Because they never give you in those budgets, this is your travel money, this is your this money. Do you ever question that money during the budget committee? Do your members interest themselves in these figures? Do they ask for the work plans? Because lately, during the budget process, they ask for work plans. Do they ask for them? Or they just know they are going to lose it because the other people have the numbers?
Mine goes to the issue of the session motion. We are the leader of opposition. We have more than 150 plus MPs. But even in the short term here, there are MPs who have not seen the last. So can you say you have totally failed to win the last? And what are you going to do for those people who have not done the session motion?
Okay, let me start with that one of Mr. Namayo. Some opposition MPs have not signed the censure motion yet. Our hope is that they will sign. Some have been away on different engagements on behalf of Parliament. They are back, some are even here. From here, they are going down to sign. So there are those that have been away for different reasons. Some have been on leave, like the Honorable Flavia Kalule, who we are very delighted to see back. She has come specifically to sign. Her leave is still ongoing, the maternity leave. She has come to sign. And others. There are those who maybe because they are friends to some of the commissioners, or they have been whipped not to sign. Our hope is that we shall speak with one voice, and I want to really put it to them that they are actually even more accountable to their constituents, their voters, than even ourselves. Because their constituents out there are saying, this is an important issue that has got to be dealt with. Our hope is that if they don't want to listen to us as leaders, at least let them listen to their voters, because their voters are saying a different thing. And our hope is that they will listen to their voters, because that's why it matters. You know, in the last parliament, there are some people who refused to listen to their voters during Tojikwatako, and they paid heavily. So there are sanctions at different levels, right? Especially that one. So our hope is that we shall speak with one voice, and our hope is that no one will see this as witch hunt. You know, in the past, the people who were saying this was the witch hunt, because we in NUP, we started this regarding our person, our own. Some people said that was an internal fight, but there are three who belong to the NRM. So you can't say this is witch hunt or whatever the case might be. We simply are saying let's rectify an illegality, an irregularity that happened. Nakasita, when do we handle commission? Nakasi, sorry. No, recently we had Kasita people. So, Rachel.
Before I get to my first question, just to mention what I've said. I've seen some of the journalists who are demobilizing and he's not decided. And then these are the lot of whoever is going to decide is a fast way.
Again, we are trying to, we've got reports of even some of our members who are demobilizing. We don't know what the incentive is, you know, because what we have heard is some are demobilizing, there is exchange of money. We have heard, I don't have any facts yet that anyone has been given money and told not to sign, but I am hearing these things. So we are trying to find out, and hopefully we'll get to the bottom of these issues, yeah, because these are, there's too much talk going around. But most importantly, I hope we can stick to the principle. An irregularity happened, let's deal with that irregularity. Rachel, when do we get to deal with commission issues? That's my concern too. As the leader of the opposition who sits on the commission, I am concerned that I don't know the affairs of the commission. I don't know when commission meetings sit, if any has sat. I've not attended any because I've not been invited to any. By the way, even the budget of the commission, it is supposed to first be discussed by the commission before it is eventually passed. Who sat as the commission? Because at least I didn't attend that meeting. Am I being kept out deliberately because they know I'm making too much noise and I will oppose certain things? Maybe, because looks like the commission is sitting somehow. But who is comprising those who are sitting? Because I am a full member of the commission. I've never, not once, since I became LOP in January, I've never got an invitation to a commission meeting. But decisions are being taken. And that's why I keep writing to the speaker, so that I am on record. So that tomorrow, no one says, you were invited and you didn't come. Where is the invitation? Because I'm the one who keeps writing and saying, when are we sitting? When will the commission sit? So it's important that there is transparency. So it's a concern that I also have. Because if meetings are not happening, if I'm not being invited to attend meetings and somebody is taking decisions somewhere, that is ultra bias, it is wrong. And that's how people get to suspect us of many things. Why are we operating in a surreptitious manner? What are we trying to hide? That even we members of the commission, like myself, I'm not invited to commission meetings. Why? Clearly, there's something fishy. That's what I can say, and we need to rectify that. And by the way, that's why we are censuring these commissioners. Because as you saw, those ones sat very quietly. I'm told how it would happen in the past. They would target when some people are away. I heard Honorable Nabanja, the Right Honorable Nabanja, Prime Minister, complaining when I was taking her on regarding Mabati issues, who are in Kalungu for a function. She said, but Honorable Senyonyi, why do you keep calling me a thief? Did you see me among the commissioners in that meeting who sat and awarded themselves money? Meaning she also had her concerns. I'm told that meeting sat when she was away and the Minister of Finance, because all of them were away. So when you target when people have traveled, for example, and you quickly call a commission meeting, such a person, that is also problematic. we must be transparent. Can you be estimate of the amounts to be spent on regional sittings? In fact, I don't even want to just estimate. That's why I'm demanding for a commission meeting, because the parliamentary commission is the one in charge of finances of this institution. And so I've written to the speaker saying the commission is supposed to sit to approve these regional sittings with a budget attached, how much in exactness is going to be passed. But now we don't know, we are simply estimating billions, of course, because if all the 529 MPs, including the 28 ex officials, because they're also members of parliament, they don't vote, but they attend our meetings and they debate and so on. So even those you can add to them. And then the numerous staff. So everything is being done quietly, which is problematic. The commission has got to sit and discuss a budget, that this is the amount going to be spent on these regional sittings. And then we discuss, is it justifiable? Should this money be spent on something else that is more relevant, more plausible? All these are issues of concern. And finally, Didan, former MPs are asking for a service award. You see, that's the problem when you set a precedent. Everyone would want it. In the last parliament, this parliament actually objected to a service award to government officials who went and they saved government a lot of money, the oil case and so on, arbitration. But you see, even when actually in reality they saved government trillions of shillings, the understanding was you people earn a salary to do that. So you were doing your job. And that's why Parliament itself objected to that service award. That committee report, by the way, was read by the Right Honourable Anita Moore, who was the then Vice Chairperson of COSASE. And Parliament passed a resolution saying, number one, this money should be refunded by these people because it was wrong. Number two, the IGG should investigate that golden handshake. You remember? So Parliament actually pronounced itself on that because it was wrong. Now here are people who are paid the salary and getting, and they've not saved the government anything or whatever the case might be, like the other ones did. Under what premise do they award themselves money? Now, when you set that precedent, everyone else will want a service award. When we were discussing the service award to the Auditor General, I said, he has benefits that he's entitled to, that's enough. And they said, how about now all other workers of government at different levels? KCCA workers are out there protesting, not for an award, for their salary that is due to them, not a service award. They are not being paid a service award, but people are being given service awards. They are saying, give us our salary for 4 months, our salary, which we are entitled to, we have worked for it. They are not getting their salary. But people who earn salaries and have benefits are given a service award. So that's why even now former MPs are saying, but wait a minute, everyone is getting a service award. We have also served the country. We should get a service award. I want to salute former members of parliament for serving this country. They set a foundation all the way from the Constituent Assembly to where we are today, and we salute them. I'm however opposed to their idea of a service award. Because who are you going to award and who won't you award? How about other public servants? Forget the politicians. They are actually public servants who have done a lot more work than us politicians. So who do you award, who do you not award? How about former police officers, some of whom are chasing their pension, not a service award, their pension for years, they have not got it. Many government employees have not got their pension. Some have died chasing for their pension. But people are being given service awards. So we object to the service award asked for by our former colleagues. No, it is not right. We thank you for serving the country, but surely, who are we going to award and who won't be awarded? What weighing scale are you going to use? Because is it true, and I say this with due respect, is it true that everyone of, okay, maybe let me not even go that direction. Because what yardstick do you get to use? There are people who, you know, parliament ends in 5 years and they have not said anything on the floor of parliament. They will they also want a service award, including this parliament of ours? There are people who since the start have not said anything. So will they also get a service award? They have their benefits and pension. Please, let's not vulgarize this issue. With due respect to our former leaders, you serve this country, Thank you. But no. Namayo yabuziza ku babaka abamu ab'opposition abatanga sayininga center motion. Twagala okukubiriza bannaffe abatanga sayininga tukole kituufu. Abamu ku bannaffe badde tebaliiwo nga batambudde ku mirimu egy'enjawulo gya Parliament, kirungi bakomyewo abamu we bali wano era nga bagenda kusayininga abamu babadde ku leave, maternity leave, nga Honorable Flavia Karolina abalala akomyewo okusayininga. So tukubiriza abali eyo bajje basayininge. Tubiwulira nti tulina bannaffe ate aboogereza bannaffe abamu nti temusayininga. Tetumanyi oba tubiwulireyo mukulu nti babawaya kasente. Simanyi, sirina bukakafu ku ekyo. Naye tubiwulira. Bwe oba toyagala sayininga, leka abagala okukola ekituufu bakikole. Kubanga tulina abamu nga bagamba nti ono omuntu ono mukwano gwange nnyo, tuvudde wala. Newankubadde yakola ekikyamu. Namba sente y'omuwomusolo tewali buzibu. Bubuusazeewo okukola bwotyo gwe ng'omukulembeze. Ate tusikiriza abalala kukola ekyo nga gugugizaako okwasaganya ensonga eyo. So tugezaako okunoonyereza ensonga zino. Naye tukubiriza bannaffe omulanga, tubakubira omulanga nti abantu be muli accountable to okusookera ddala be balonzi bammwe. Nga temunabeera n'accountable kufi bakulembeze bannammwe naye abalonzi, ate abalonzi bavuddeyo ku nsonga eno. Temubeera nga bannaffe abali mu Paalamenti ewedde togikwatako. Abalonzi bagamba temugikwatako mpaka yeena ajja n'agikwatako. Mwabalaba abasinga tebadda na kudda. So tukole ekituufu n'abalonzi kye batusuubiramu. Rachel abuuziza ku nsonga za commission. Munnange nange kyagala nnyo ensonga ezikwata ku Parliamentary Commission zireme kubeera mu nsuntu. Nze neemulugunya nti ojanga nfuuka leader of opposition, ndi memba wa commission, naye siyitibwanga mu meeting n'egyo. Neemu. Ate ng'emirimu gitambula, sente zisaasaanyibwa. Ani atuula nga Parliamentary Commission? Oba bagiyita neetuula nze nga tebampise. Era nga njagala ntegeere lwaki, ki kye bankweka. Lwakubanga njogera nnyo ku nsonga zino ate nga sigenda kusirika. Naye ndi full member of the commission, lwaki siyitibwa? Ebintu bikolebwa mu nkukutu. So tulina okubeera abalambulukufu obulungi ku nsonga zino eza Parliamentary Commission kubanga ebigenda maaso bikyamu. Nali eyo Kalungu ku mukolo ogumu oweekitiibwa Nabbanja naye yaliyo, ne mmubuuza ku nsonga ez'amabaati, bwegenda okwogera n'agambe ne Europe, lwaki ompita omubbi? Nze wandabako mu Parliamentary Commission waaba abeegabira ssente. Kitegeeza naye yakiraba nti kikyamu. Ate mu meeting eyo teyaliiwo, mpulira oluusi baalinanga abantu abamu tebaliiwo. Ono atambudde noono ne bagiyita mangu mangu. Ekyo kiba kikyamu. Naye nze sifunanga ku invitation okutuula mu Parliamentary Commission. Kyogola bampandiika amabaluwa kangamba ndi Madam Speaker. Lwaki tutuuza commission ne twogera ku nsonga zino? Mwami Kajubi, yes, estimate ya regional sittings. Sina na estimate ate sina kubanga nteebereza buteebereza. Kyogola bangamba nti Parliamentary Commission yali tudde ne tufuna budget embalirira nti bwe tunaagenda eggulu sente mmeka ezigenda okusaasaanyibwa buwumbi bumeka, bwe tunaagenda embaale Masaka mbalala sente mmeka, tukikubeko ebirowoozo tukiyise oba tukigaane. Naye tetunnafuna mukisa ogwo. Kyogula waffe tugamba nti nedda enkola eno si ntuufu. Finally, Didan abuziza ku nsonga y'abaali ababaka abavuddeyo ku nsonga y'akasiimo nga nabo basaba akasiimo. Sookera ddala njagala kwebaza abaali ababaka kubira ddala mu Constituent Assembly baze baweereza eggwanga era emirimu tujje tuze tugiraba nga tubeebaza tubasiima nga bannayuganda. Naye kino ate eky'okusaba akasiimo abannayi mutuleke muko kubanga mwafuna ng'omusaala mulina benefits na ki. Naye kati bwe tunaagamba nti kakati twongereko n'akasiimo, buli omu agenda kusaba akasiimo. Kati akasiimo tukawaani tulekaani? Kubanga n'abakozi ba gavumenti abataali babaka nabo baweereza eggwanga oluusi n'okusinga ababaka abamu. Kuba tulina ababaka abamu ekisanja kiggwanga tayogerangako ku floor ya Parliament kati naye n'asaba akasiimo. Nedda bannange, sigambye nti ababaka abaali ababaka mbu tebaakola mirimu, baagikola twagirabanga. Naye bwe tunaagamba nti kakati buli omu afuna akasiimo, kigenda kuyitirira, sente ezo teziriiwo. Kati budget eno gye twayisa obutabalika n'obunsanvu mu bubiri, URA ekuŋŋaanya buli obutabalika nga 2 mu 3 kwa 2 mu 5. So tuleme kisusa nnyo tulina abakozi ba KCC abali mu kwekalakaasa ebweru awo bo tebasaba kasimo basaba musaala gwabwe gwe bakoleredde emyezi era tebannasasulibwa kati bano tebannafuna musaala gwabwe ate abalala baagala kasimo nedda bannange tuleme kususa nnyo nsonga eno otherwise kijja kwonooneka tube nga tetulina ngeri gye tukikontrolinga. Abagamba nti tetusoma biwandiiko babitulage biwandiiko kye bitutasoma kubanga nze mbagambye nti ministerial policy statement mu ripoti ya Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee ekunanyizibwa ku Parliamentary Commission ne mu budget temuliimu service award akawumbi kamu mu milioni 7 eza Honorable Mpuuga, Honorable Silwani, Honorable Kampulira ne Honorable Afoyutani teziriimu documents zirina kati abagamba nti biri mu document bazitulage bajeyo hazard eraga nti ekintu kino kyateesebwako nga bwe twasenteesa ku benefits ez'abaspiika abaali baspiika nga bwe twasenteesa ku benefits za auditor general naki bajeyo hansard kubanga hansard yo terimba tubasaba bajeyo hansard ensonga eno twagikuba okuganya kutta ebirowoozo baleme kujja kumala kwogera ngambo nakimbu tetusoma kale mwe abasoma ate abagulwa kubasaagala balabisa saawa zino tebajja mu paalamenti era tebatera kuteesa. So kakati tumanyi oba be basoma babere nga bateesa n'abaana baabwe mayumba gaabwe naye kale oba bo basoma batulage kye basoma ffe kyetwasoma bajeyo hansard eraga nti ensonga eno yateesebwako bagitulage teriyo for our colleagues who keep insinuating that you see some colleagues don't read. I want to challenge them again because I have all the documents, the ministerial policy statement, the report of the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee that is concerned with the commission, the budget. There is no such thing as a service award of 1.7 billion for Honorable Mpuuga, Honorable Silwani, Honorable Afoyutani, and Honorable Kampulira. It is not there. I challenge them to produce it. And I challenge them to produce the answer where this issue was debated. Because all the other awards were debated to former speakers and so on, to the Auditor General, even though we had our disagreements, at least it was debated. I challenge them to produce the answer where this matter was debated. It's not there. So stop confusing people, surely.
Chief Whip of Land, Aba Enarim, Sainega,
Okay. Is that the same question?
Yeah, it's the same. What do you make of it as your position? Do you feel like it is something that keeps happening at top? It's a frustrating. You're here, you're putting out a little energy, but the process starts and then in the middle of it.
You know, I have said before, and I will say again, that when you fight corruption, it fights back. Yeah. When you fight corruption, it fights back. So as we are dealing, fighting against these irregularities, they are fighting back in various ways. That's why we are hearing some people are giving money. We don't know. But please, let no leader work their name come out to defend an irregularity. Let's deal with the irregularities. And again, I want to appreciate leaders in NRA who have spoken out. The Deputy Secretary General, Honorable Rose Namayo, NRA, spoke out on this issue, saying this was wrong. And I appreciate her. I applaud her. She belongs to a different party. And I'm glad she spoke out. And other NRM leaders, in fact, NRM leaders, MPs, are the ones at the forefront of this, together with some of our colleagues. And we appreciate them. So those who are discouraging people, choose which side of history you want to be on. Bannaffe, abafayo okulemesa abo abateeka emikono ku censure motion, bwe ne tubabuuza, mwe lwaki mwagala okubeera ku sayidi y'ekikyamu? Nga bwe nzize ngambye nti olwanyisa enguzi, naye kulwanyisa. So kakati kyekiriwo, kakati abo abagezaako okulemesa mukolera ani? Mukolera bannayuganda oba mulina abalala be mukolera? Njagala kwebaza kubanga si nti buli omukulembeze wa NRM avuddeyo okuwakanya ekintu kino. Oweekitiibwa Rose Namayanja, Deputy Secretary General wa NRM, yavaayo n'ayogera ku nsonga eno n'agamba kino kikyamu. Okay, Minisita Namuganza yasayinize abakikulembera bano ba NRM n'abaffe era njagala okubeebaza tituli mu kibiina kye kimu naye ku nsonga eno waakiri bavudde ne bagamba kino kikyamu tutambulire awo.